Praise the Lord. Good morning. This is Seed of Word in Ministry, and I am Ametta.
I sought the Lord, and He answered me, and delivered me from every fear. Those who look on Him are radiant, they'll never be ashamed, they'll never be ashamed.
Amen. God has saved us by His name. Hallelujah. He saved us. Amen. Amen. I am so glad we can meet this morning. Hallelujah. And it is good to see the comments that I have been given on the website. So I thank you, those who have offered up, amen, and shared what they felt about or what they didn't like about the episodes. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I just lift up the listeners to You today, Lord God, that You would have mercy on them and comfort them and lead them into the pathway that You want them to go for this day. We give You praise and glory and honor, for there is no other name other than Yours whereby we can be saved. We thank You, Lord God, for wisdom and knowledge of Your word and the ability to apply it to our lives. We ask these things in Jesus' name. And also, Lord, look down upon those who have lost loved ones, who have contracted the virus, who have lost their jobs, who are in need of finances. Lord God, be the God that Israel has taught us through the word of God that You are, and that we have come to believe that You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider God. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Today, I want to share some thoughts about the centrality of Jesus. How important is Jesus to us? That word centrality means the quality of being essential or of greatest importance. The scripture teaches us that Jesus is of great importance to us for salvation, for healing, oh God, and even for peace. I think we all can agree that we need help, and the things that we were doing before Christ was not bringing us the help that we needed. We tried eating and sex and drugs, and their effects might have lasted a while, but then their false effects no longer took care of the changes that we were looking for. We were in situations that seemed we could not get out of. So come with me and listen to some of these scriptures. In Romans 3 and 23, it says, "We have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God." Somebody mentioned to me that I needed to be saved. I needed Christ. So I began to search the scriptures. And John 3:16 was read to me. And I was told to take out the word world and whoever and put my name in its place and read it aloud. So it sounded something like this. "For God so loved Ometa that He gave His Son, that Ometa believes in Him should not perish, but have ever eternal life." It was not grammatically correct, but it got the message over to me. And then I began to study and understand Jesus' importance to me. Let me read some of those scriptures that proved to me I needed Him. I read in Acts 2 and 38 these words. "And Peter said to them, 'Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus for the forgiveness of sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Wonderful. I could be forgiven for my sins, and it was in Jesus' name. I was then told about Isaiah 53, but he was wounded for our transgression. He was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement of our peace, and with his stripes we are healed. Chastisement, I looked it up. It is the act of scolding and punishing someone. This chastisement was not only physical through the beatings that he received, but also through verbal talking to him. It had been reported in Deuteronomy 25 and 3 that he was only to receive 40 stripes and no more, unless the people that saw you doing it would see you degraded in front of them. The scriptures do not exactly tell us how many stripes Jesus received, but we know we received them for our healing. Paul mentions 39. In Romans 10:8, but what does it say? That the word is near you and in your heart. That is the word of faith, which we preach. If you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Jesus again. In 1 Peter, he himself bore our sins on the cross, that we might die to sin and live to righteousness. By his wounds, have you been saved? Have you been healed? Amen. Wow. Through Jesus Christ again. These two verses really clinched it for me, and they are found in Acts 4:11. Jesus is the stone you rejected, which has become the cornerstone. Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind which you can be saved. So you see, salvation, healing, peace, eternal life is all in Jesus Christ. I think that makes him essential. That is the centrality of Jesus Christ. Amen. If you agree with me, make a comment in the bottom or where you subscribed. Stay masking, stay distancing, wear gloves when necessary, and remember, Jesus is centrality of salvation. Amen. Be blessed of the Lord. It's Wednesday. The weekend is coming, and I am going to talk more about the centrality of Jesus Christ when we return. I love you, but Jesus loves you more.